Welcome to our production of The Lion King. I actually wrote this about 12 years ago for a group of kids that I just started with. I've had them maybe 6 months or so. A lot of these kids I've had for 7 years or so. So they're actually doing the real choreography that I envisioned 12 years ago, which is really cool. It's a compilation of the movie The Lion King and the production Lion King, which I've never gotten to see. So you all that's actually seen the production, you're one up on me. This was totally in my imagination. So forgive me if it pales in comparison. A couple changes in the program. There's always mistakes, and I'm sorry that I left a couple of names out. One of them, when you see the giraffes, I left off Destiny and Buchanan. Very sorry, Destiny. Also, Pumbaa, who's the warthog, was left off too, and that's played by Holly Durbin and Cassie Livers, not at the same time, but. The main ostrich, there is a main ostrich, and that is Taylor Wolf, not Jocelyn Spaulding. I think that's all the changes. Ed is played by Holly. Thank you very much, Rafiki. This is Rafiki. This is the wise baboon. For you all that don't know the story, she's very wise. Okay, if you will, please try to leave the aisles clear because they're used by the kids periodically. So stay away from the aisles. The first three rows were marked off because there's not a real good visibility from the first three rows for one thing. And then after the production of The Lion King, all of our team kids are going to exhibit what they've worked on and take about 30 minutes. So all the Lion King performers will be able to sit in those seats there. And I think that's about it. Thank you all for coming. I hope you enjoy the show.
Take you to a faraway land in the jungles of Africa. The sun is rising, his animal herds gather around Pride Rock to celebrate with King Mufasa and Sarabi the arrival of Simba, their newborn prince. Scar, Mufasa's jealous younger brother, sits in the shadow, absent from the ceremony, with his soon-to-be army of hyenas. As Simba is presented, the animals are overjoyed and full of hope for a bright and wonderful future. Mysterious baboon named Rafiki returns to his home in a deep, dark cave. He sketches Simba on the cave wall, a ritual to keep him safe from all harm. Rafiki has thoughts of a prosperous future under the reign of a new king someday. in the Pride Lands. As Simba matures, Mufasa often speaks to Simba about the circle of life and the endless chain that binds all living things together. As Mufasa tells Simba one day he will be king, Zazu, the king's messenger, comes to give the morning report. However, Simba has other things on his mind.
It's an honor and a privilege, a duty I perform with due sense of decorum and with pride. With deference and great respect, very much the norm, plus a hint of sycophancy on the side. To lay before my ruler all the facts about his realm, to fill him in on all the beastly news.
Yes, yes, Zazu, get on with it.
In order that his majesty stand sturdy at the helm, aware of all the fauna's latest news.
Zazu, the morning report.
Yes, sire, the morning report. Chimps are going ape, giraffes remain above it all. Elephants remember, though just what I can't recall. Crocodiles are snapping up fresh offers from the banks. Showed interest in my nest egg, but I quickly said, no thanks. We haven't paid the hornbills, and the vultures have a hunch. Not everyone invited will be coming back from lunch. This is the morning report. Gives you the law. Every grunt, roar, and snort, long tail I distort, on the morning report.
What are you doing, son?
Bouncing.
Ah, let it all through, shall we bounce down?
The buffalo have got a peep about this season's grass. Water attempts to save their gas.
Yes, they
flamingos in the bay are chasing secretary birds. A saffron is the season's color, seen in all the herds. Moving jackals shrinking while too near the bottom rung. Far too many beetles are quite frantic in the dung.
Pounce!
Outside the Pride Land boundaries. Simba's curiosity of the graveyard overwhelms him, and he convinces the gullible young lioness, Nala, to explore it with him. Before venturing to the graveyard, they must plot their escape from Zazu, their watchful feathered guardian, with a little help from their friends.
Or beasts with quite so little care.
I'm gonna be the main event.
What they do not realize is lurking in the shadows are three hyenas sent by Scar, who had anticipated the cub's arrival. Joined by their friends, the hyenas make plans for a tasty meal.
Mangy!
Did I hear stupid?
Tell us again, Gee!
It's so incredible.
That you are so rude.
When you're so edible.
When you are good.
It's time to chow down.
Simba for going beyond the Pride Land boundaries. However, at the same time, the king is relieved that his son is safe. Mufasa tells Simba, Mamela, which means he will always be there with him, if not in flesh, then in the spirit, the same as all the kings of the past.
Ikuna, Ikuna, Ikuna. of a child. Ask for my milk.
Of both Mufasa and Simba so he can be king. First, Scar must convince the hyenas to follow and help him. And thus, the hyena army is born under Scar's control by his promise of a prosperous future with plenty of food. Scar again betrays Mufasa by leading his beloved son to an empty river gorge where Simba is supposed to wait for his father's. Scar then cues the hyenas to start a stampede of wild beasts, which will certainly trample Simba to death.
They have a glimmer of potential. If allied to my vision and brain.
Bounds of redemption are as wet as a warthog's backside. But thick as you are, pay attention. My words are a matter of pride. It's clear from your vacant expression the lights in the hall are not there.
But we are talking kings and successions. Even you can't be caught unawares.
So prepare for the chance of a lifetime. Be prepared for sensational news. A shining new era is tiptoeing nearer.
And where do we reach?
Just listen to teacher. I know it sounds sordid, but you'll be rewarded when at last I am given my dues. And the injustice deliciously square. Be prepared.
Yeah!
pyramids littered with prizes. And though I may see, the point that I must emphasize is,
you won't get a sniff without me!
Mufasa discovers his son is in grave danger. He rushes to rescue Simba. Once Simba is out of harm's way, Mufasa is pulled down by the overwhelming strength of the stampede. Simba is devastated by his father's death and is unsure where to turn. Scar convinces Simba it is his fault that his father is gone, and he must run away and never return so he will not have to face the condemnation of the lionesses. Scar tells the Lionesses about Mufasa and Simba are dead, and in his place floors King, keeping his promise to the Hyenas, he allows them to invade the Pride Lands. Rafiki, upset by the news, begins an ancient funeral chant of mourning. He is not only saddened by the death of Mufasa and Simba, but also disgusted by the condition of the Pride Lands. The once prosperous outlook for the future of the kingdom is now possibly lost forever to the foolishness of Scar. To a desert where he collapses from exhaustion. He is saved from certain death by Pumbaa, a lively warthog, and his meerkat friend, Timon. They carry him to their home in a jungle paradise. As they nurse him back to health, they introduce him to their philosophy in life, the Hakuna Matata, which means no cares at all, and tell him it is best to forget his past entirely. And so it happens that Simba, the lost prince, grows to manhood far, far away from the Pride Lands.
Hakuna Matata ain't no peasant craze. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's all problem free.
Praise. Means no worries for the rest of your days.
Badlands become an ugly, barren land. The balance of life has been disturbed by the enormous appetite of the hyena army, and the herds of animals have moved on. Scar, who once thought being king is all he needed to be happy, is still miserable and as jealous as ever of his brother.
Scar, you have to do something. We're being forced to overhunt.
She's got those assets feminine.
The king, control the
queen. I have to make her buy.
Destroy the pride lands.
Nobility in every king.
If we stop now, don't you
see? She has to be my queen.
There's still a chance for things to be all right again.
Come, sweetheart. It's written in the stars.
What are you doing? Are you listening to me?
We'll create a hostile little skies. Tell me I You know how I loathe violence. One way or another, you will be mine.
Never, Scar. Never.
You belong to me.
Before leaving, Nala vows to never forget her family.
Oh,
assumed. His every day's with us on his dream. In short, our battle is
rather than hiding from it. Nala, Timon, and Pumbaa follow behind him in hopes that they can help. Simba knows this will be the most difficult trial of his life and hopes he is prepared.
Thank you.
Pride Lands for Simba, the rightful king.
What would it do? Dress a dragon to the hula? Wow! If you hungry for a hunk of fat, juicy meat, eat my funny cola here because he has a dream. Tell the dollar nine, let us take his wine. All you have to do is get mine. Ah, yeah, yeah, get up, yup, yup. Oh, it's a pig, get up, yup, yup. He's a big pig, yup, yup. You can be a big pig too. Oi, oi.
Well, we did make it, didn't we? What a good job you guys did. Just a couple of glitches that we'll just miss, okay? Okay, at this time, we're going to spend about 30 minutes watching our teen kids. They spend a lot of time in the gym, and it takes a lot of training. So I would like for you to stick around and watch them. It won't take but about 30 minutes. I've left a space for the performers to sit. So at this time, if you are not on tumble team, dance team, or a cheerleader, I tell you what, I'm gonna call your names out as you go down, okay? All right, we'll start with a program. And if mommies could kind of help the lines and the lionesses, if y'all don't mind them, to come down here. Or Cindy, can you come and help escort them down? I'm gonna start with the little lions. We have Emily Bibbin. Come here, Amy. Okay, and now we have Paige Buckman. Anybody know Paige? Hey, Paige! Paige! Can you wave? Say hi. There you go. Okay, next we have Hannah Butts. Come here, Hannah. Right here. Turn around. There you go. Good job. Now go right over there. Follow the steps right over there. There you go. Good job. And Summer Cowan. And Mackenzie Greenwell, our youngest performer. Okay. Jagger Hayes. Marple.
Deborah Marks. And Brett.
Okay, we have Nina Martin. Go James. I'm gonna skip here, I don't need this. We have Abby James. We have Holly Durbin.
What?
Holly Greenwald. Okay, maybe I didn't remember. We need, oh, Tesla Wright. Rafiki. And we have little Nala.
Oh yeah, that's me.
That's Riley. And we have little Simba. And Zazu. And we have Big Simba that doubled. And we have Holly Durbin, who played Ed. And Pumbaa, and Cassie also doubled as Pumbaa, that's why she's dressed like that. And Macy Simpson, who played Timon. And Ashley Gerton, who played Sarabi. And our two main other main hyenas right here, Banshee and Shinzi or something like that. Those, these guys. And then I have Allie, come here Allie. Allie's my only senior. She played Big Noah because she said so. She was threatening to break people's legs if they took her part. Just kidding, kind of. Good job, Allie, thank you. Okay, at this time, we're gonna let the team kids. We all love and we're so proud of our kids, but there's somebody else here today that loves our kids and is proud of them just as much as we are. They've become her children too, and that is Miss Lori. Here's your pair of scissors. So you can open this. No, it's not going to bite you. But Miss Lori dedicates herself to our kids, and they become her children just as much as they're ours. Now, while she's getting this out, as soon as she sees what it is, I have something to read to y'all. Okay, it's a blanket. And the blanket says, Coach, as our coach, we just wanted you to know how much we appreciate every sacrifice you have made. You have helped us grow as a team and as individuals. We have learned that hard work really does pay off and that excellence can be achieved. You have been our biggest fan during our most triumphant moments and our rock when we came up short of our goal. We can only hope that we have touched your life as profoundly as you have touched ours. Thank you for making a difference. We love you, Miss Lori. And sorry about that, it's from Caitlin Butler, Maddie LaValle, Tierra Moore, Macy Simpson, Kenzie Joyner, Raylan Wolf, Ashley Wolf, Michaela Butler, Nina Martin, Whitney Moore, Jocelyn Spalding, Jayla Marble, and Peyton Wilson. Okay, let me recover. Hold on. talk about what just happened right now, but